see the USA in your Chevrolet. America is asking you to call. Drive your Chevrolet through the USA. America's the greatest land of all. On a highway or a road along a levee, performance is sweeter, nothing can beat her. Life is completer in a Chevy. So make a date today to see the USA.
What are you doing today?
Working the registration booth.
What are you doing today?
We're helping park all these phenomenal cars.
Yes.
Doesn't get any better than this.
Six Buick Regal T-Type Turbo. I've owned the car about 10 years. Started out as my daily driver, then I got in a car accident and decided to restore it.
Oh, wow.
The original, and put a bigger turbo in it with better trans, and now it's just a fun car to drive.
Well, there you go.
Yeah.
Did you pick out your car yet?
Did you? No, she likes them all.
Oh, she likes them all.
I got 35 years in, and here at the lovely car show. I got my first Mustang here, and I got a Mustang because I've had it 40 years. Great show, try and be here next year.
Hi, I'm Don Freeman Jr. This is my 2011 Mustang. I love coming out to the show. I've been coming to the show since I was a little kid. It's a great thing GM puts on for all the employees, and I get to come here with my dad and his 1972 Mustang.
so long. Hi, I'm Steve Westfall. I live in Armada, Michigan, retired from General Motors. I bought this 1967 Camaro 21 years ago. It was originally in 94 in a Hot Rod magazine, a three-page article that I still have. It's a Corvette six-speed with a 502 crate motor that I put together. And it's got a Dana 60 rear axle with 513 gears in it. So it's a real stump puller. It'll get up and move. I put street legal slicks on it, and it helps it, you know, not spin so much, I should say. So.
Hi, my name is Al Oppenheiser. I'm the Camaro Chief Engineer. And today is a great day for our GM employees. This is our annual GM Tech Center Car Show. We're lucky enough on the Camaro team to be able to support it this year because we're celebrating 50 years of the Chevrolet Camaro. So if you look around to my right, you'll see a big yard full of employee Camaros. Great to see. To my left and behind me, we've got one of all the new performance variants that came out in 2017 and 18. So everything from this ZL11 LE Camaro is just blistered rear ring in 7 minutes and 16 seconds, to our SS1 LEs, our convertible ZL1s. So come on up, take a look. It's a wonderful experience. The people that organize this do such a nice job. They actually located by our design center so that we get to get more space. Gives you a great thing, great chance to walk around and look and see what's behind every employee's passion for cars, what drives them to be a GM employee. There's some beautiful classics here. But again, we're very proud to be part of 50 years of Camaro and the GM employee Tech Center Car Show.
Here.
Oh, now you take pictures out here.
Come on.
Wow, where's
hey.
You been?
Hey.
We're driving around.
Hey, beep, beep.
Unbelievable.
Good boy, baby.
He's got to be
looking at his daddy.
Yeah. Sitting in it?
Sure.
What's the button on the floor there?
That's the starter.
Push that, oh, so it's got electric.
Oh, yeah.
That's engaged. Right, engaged. Yep. And it's, oh, he's going to die. He's not here.
Gentlemen, if I could have your attention, please. If you could please refrain from what you're doing now as we officially begin our show. The Michigan Volunteer Defense Force Color Guard will be coming up towards the stage area, marching with our colors. They'll be presenting our colors. And once the colors are posted, we will play our national anthem. So let the show begin.
Well,
good morning and welcome to each and every one of you to the GM Tech Center for our annual employee car show, UAW GM Car Show. For our opening remarks this morning, I would like to welcome Mr. Mike Simcoe, Vice President of Global Design, for our opening remarks.
Wow. Good morning, everybody. This is a wonderful event, and the weather, well, the sun's starting to come out, but we'll see how that goes. I've got a couple of things to say and a couple of people to thank, particularly for this event. I guess it's a welcome to the event today. This is the GM Tech Center and UAW Local 160 Car Show, although this is cars, bikes, lots of toys and trucks and everything else that everyone's brought along. So it should be a wonderful day. Now to help kick off, I have the president of Local 160, Dave Small. So welcome, Dave. And Earl Fuller, I think, is on site here somewhere. So if you could welcome them, I'd appreciate it. I'm filling in this morning for Mark Royce. He sends his apologies. He's very disappointed not to be here, but he's out working while we're having fun, so don't feel too bad. I'd also like to recognise that Dan Ammon will be here around about noon, I think, and he's got his 61 Cadillac sitting across in a tent just over here, so anyone who's interested, spend some time with Dan, twist his arm and talk to him about the company and how you feel about it. This is no better opportunity than today. I think that the show itself demonstrates the partnership that exists between UAW and GM folk. And also, I'd like to acknowledge the work that's happening on this site. GM and UAW have partnered to expand the site and do a renovation, which is you can see around you. The car show itself is a wonderful thing, and there's no better place to do it really than on this site. There's a lot of heritage here, but what better to do it on the site where you're beside the lake, you're in the shadow of the design building, the engineering building, manufacturing, and R&D. But the place where the majority of the vehicles in this crowd were generated and created many, many years ago. Now, GM's always been a leader. Technology's a big thing to us. It's come and gone, but again, GM is on the rise, and we are now a leader in electrification, autonomy, fuel cell, and mobility in general. The company is changing to suit a changing industry, and we're part of that, which is incredibly exciting. So I think that's a big message for this show as well. The show is bigger than ever, and for that I'd like to thank Jim Suzak and his team of volunteers. The show gets better every year, so thank you, Jim. I'd like to recognise that too. We are celebrating today the 50th anniversary of the Camaro, and if you look down to the south of the lake there, you'll see all those Camaros parked. All the generations are represented there, so please get down and have a look and talk to the enthusiasts who brought the cars along today. And we also need to recognise DJ Rock and Ronnie.
Mike Simcoe. He's the captain now of Design Building. Very excited to have him. Couldn't ask for a better partnership than that, and a gentleman to lead design into the future. Yeah, but let's talk about the past just for a second. Okay, 1956, right? May of 1956, dedicated the GM Tech Center. The grounds right here that you now stand, 1956. 6 months later, we opened up a UAW, two-house bungalow on Mound Road, which was Local 160, 1956. Very significant dates for this site. 2014, they deemed the GM Tech Center an historical landmark. What a history. I mean, what a history we are now standing amongst. It's amazing. And again, I want to thank all the workers here, the salary folks, hourly folks. You'll see them out here in their shirts. Take a moment to thank them, because what a success story this is to run this, the biggest lunchtime car show in the world. This, the biggest. Very excited to be representing the 2,000 UAW members, the 5,000 or so retirees, Local 160. And thank you again for the salary partnership to get this off the ground. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Mike Simcoe, Mr. Dave Small. And are you ready to rock and roll?
Go! How is your day going so far?
It's fun. And interesting. There's a lot of cars? Yes.
Which one do you like the best?
I can't.
Too many to choose?
Yeah. Too many. Way too many to choose. There's so many of the old and new. It's awesome.
I'm Amanda Fantoski. I work in the back as a PFMEA facilitator. And I think the car show is really neat. Just to be out here and see all the different cars and that the employees can show the off their vehicles and just have a fun day.
So this is the world's first solar utility vehicle. It's a four-door, four-seat vehicle that's based for practicality, very efficient vehicle that will be racing in Australia in October.
Gorgeous.
This is my baby.
That's your baby.
I bought this car for my daughter, but she made the Dean's List. This is the fourth year she made the Dean's List.
Go, baby, 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 go,
name's Chris Olson. Work at AEC, Alternative Energy Center, Tech Center. We're here today at the GM Car Show, and I brought my 92 Mustang. It has a 351 Windsor in it that I stroked it out to a 393. Still under construction.
It's a 31 Chrysler CM6, so it was the bottom of the Chrysler line, but styled like their larger cars, the Imperial and the Custom Imperial, which is why I like it for the radiator cover, the grille. It has a six-cylinder engine. This has an overdrive out of a 34, even though it's a 31. Otherwise, it's largely original. The brakes are original, which means they're hydraulic. It means the master cylinder is smaller than on my mountain bike, and it means it almost stops from 40. The top speed is around 70.
Great show today. Built my 69 Corvette right here.
I have my 2003 Corvette. I've been coming here for a long time.
I like yours better.
No, that's not going.
I'm just kidding.
Corvettes are great.
Yes. Both retirees.
Hi, I'm Lori Hutton, and this is my husband and I, 1955 GMC pickup truck. Now, the story goes he's always wanted a GMC, and it's a three-quarter ton. They're hard to find, GMCs. You can find a lot of Chevys, but GMCs are a little more difficult. Over here, as you might be able to see, it has a GMC mustache emblem, which is hard to find. But we are truck appreciators, and this one is used as a truck. You know, throw things in the back and it still works. Now, it came from California, someone else had it, put in a V8 engine in it, made it operable, but it's just very loved and we appreciate it for what it is.
My name is Joe Payne. I'm out of Pontiac, Michigan. I'm a retired General Motors employee. I got a 1975 Chevy 5-1 coupe. And, 1975 Chevy 5-1 coupe. I restored it from scrap. It was in real bad shape when I got the car and when I started working on it. I've been working on this car. It took me about 3 years to finish this car up. And I got a 502 crate mold in here, 700R trans, 9-inch Ford rear end, Mustang 2 front end.
Another excellent car show. A lot of cars here today, old and new. A lot of people. Everybody seems to be enjoying themselves. Steve and I have made a video. Hopefully that works out okay. The weather was good. It looked like rain in the morning, but it didn't. The sun came out, and so we all had a great time.
I enjoyed it. This is, I feel, that the best turnout ever. I think it's more cars, more people, more variety of food, and I've met a lot of interesting people here today. A lot of people that don't even work here are coming here, saying it must be really cool to work here to see all these great looking cars and to work for this company. So yeah, I enjoy it.